Hello, YouTube friends. It's Brad from the Big Family Homestead. And let me tell you what, today I have something super cool to share with you. And dare I say, maybe, yeah, no, straight up, it's a blessing. So here we go. This broken down, falling in barn roof that's rotten, been there for a long time, has made it through the winter. This thing was on its last leg and was for sure to come down. And we've got animals right in there. We've got pigs, and then further down are our chickens. It is a huge, huge, amazing thing that it lasted the winter, and I wanna show you why. Even out here, if you look, the glass block has been busting out from the pressure of that roof coming down in funky places. This was danger, danger city. This roof beam tells a big story, doesn't it? But that's only the half of it. Let me show you what's really going on here with the water damage. Now, who knows how long this roof has been like this, but it's pretty much rotten out and it's falling apart. And this, my friends, is a huge blessing. A huge blessing? What the heck are you talking about, Brad? That roof is coming down. You got animals there, kids, you know, the potential. I'm standing under it right now. You gotta be out of your mind. It's gotta cost you tons of money to get this stupid thing repaired. How the heck did it make it through the winter anyway? Yes, actually, it is a huge blessing. If you take a look at that trussing that was put up there, that bracing, that actually was it was put up by myself, my daughter Claire, and a friend to the channel. And this cost us very little money, only a couple hours, and let me explain why I say this is a huge blessing. Yes, yes, yes. There's time, money, effort, and not the least of things, danger involved with this roof here. It's only a matter of time till it either needs to be replaced or come down. But when we got into this place, we really didn't know what exactly we were getting into. We didn't know about that roof. And so when we discovered the potential of what could happen, it was like, oh my gosh, what are we gonna do? We don't have the money. There's no way. We're gonna have to maybe destroy this part of the barn. We had no idea what was gonna happen. And a friend of the channel said, you know what, I got a solution. I can do this, and I can do this, and it won't cost you very much, pretty much anything, and we can reuse the wood when we're done, and it's gonna fix it. It's gonna get you through the winter. And he came over and fixed it with us. And so what was a potential tragedy, humongous source of irritation and possible money loss, has made it through the winter. We've got wood we can use, built more friendships, blessings out of nowhere. Ooh, my face looks crazy. Blessings out of nowhere, guys. Looking for those things in our lives that could have been horrible, or might even be horrible, but finding the good in the everyday and even the bad stuff. Here's another example. Let me go and show you another example. This goat, Petunia, those little babies are not her babies. She actually had her goat that she just had, her baby goat, did not survive. She was the one that the goat came out and the goat was not alive. Now, that's kind of a weird way to say this is a huge blessing. Well, first of all, see those little ones? Let me tell you a little bit more about what's going on here. Yes, those little ones are not her babies. But the thing is this, we have been trying to build up our milking animals because of our daughter Grace. You know, our daughter Grace has special needs. She eats through a G-tube, and one of the best things in the world she can get is the super freshest food, the rawest food she can get. And well, goat milk and cow's milk fit that bill to a T. And basically, we have been trying to build our herd up, but we're on a limited budget. Well, While Petunia had lost her baby, that really stinks, well, her body kind of kicked into lactation. And so while she was given a little bit of milk, we started to milk her, and she gave a little bit more, and she gave a little bit more. And now the babies go from mama to mama, and we've got it balanced out where Petunia's given us a whole lot more milk for our daughter, Grace, but she's also sharing with the babies, and mama's, everybody's taken care of, and it's awesome. And so blessings out of bad things around you that you may go, gosh, this is horrible. But then it can be used to make something beautiful. And we didn't expect to have another lactating animal. Hi, speaking of lactating animals, here's one that we're working on right now. She's gonna be another Macy. But blessings out of nothing, guys. You gotta look at the positive in things and not just dwell on the negative. It'll eat you alive. Let me share another one that this will blow you away. And then I got another one after that that'll probably top them all. Right here is where it happened. My son and my daughter, Claire, were driving home from school. 50 miles an hour, 60 miles an hour, mostly highway driving, five-ish miles, and no problems. They pull into the driveway, they get out of the car. We're moving vehicles around because we've got to do something with animals and trailers. And my wife gets into the vehicle, drives it 10 feet, and then it won't stop. It won't stop at all. The brake line had, for whatever reason, just rotted through, and at that moment had not the ability to stop anymore. It was just done. I almost smashed into another car. And when I'm talking about blessings out of what potentially could be bad, I am blown away, because when you think about it, they could have been driving. It was moments before. They were driving 60 miles an hour. And if you look around here, everything's still snow. It was way worse. It was way worse. I'm talking like a foot worse of snow. And it could have been bad. Blessings out of nothing. You got to think, okay, I could be irritated about the brakes giving out, but that'd be absolutely asinine when you consider my kids could have been driving 60 miles an hour with no brakes moments before. And it's not just that. That car has another blessing. Just a few days after we had gotten the brakes fixed on that Escape, Jonathan and another friend named Jonathan were actually doing some work for us. They were out in a field, and I actually at this moment I can't remember exactly what they were doing. I think we were, I don't know, I can't remember, it doesn't matter. But they were using the Escape to do it. Well, for one reason or another, whatever happened that they were doing, the Escape's frame, the actual frame of the vehicle, had been so rusted out that it snapped in two. I could look at that as, oh my gosh, I gotta buy another car. I could look at that as, oh my gosh, what a hassle. Or I could look at it like, well, my sons Jonathan and friend Jonathan were ingenuitive enough to figure out a way to drive it backwards, just across the street, a mile here, not even, maybe a half mile altogether, probably less. But they drove it backwards. They figured out how to get it done. Then they strapped it all together. They strapped the frame together with towing straps and got it over to a buddy's house. Hassle, money, or huge blessing. They could have been driving. Once again, they could have been driving. It could have been horribly bad. Instead, I've got to view it like, oh man, this is amazing. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. But it gets even better than that. Let me share one more with you. And this one for me is the icing on the cake. We have traditionally not done a lot of Facebook or Twitter or a lot of the social media platforms, not because we're against them or anything like that, but they become black holes of our time. And we feel like people get offended or upset if you don't respond to their comment or whatever it is they're trying to do, if they're trying to do an event or whatever. And so we kind of got to the point where we were just like, people are taking this all the wrong way. And so when we moved from Ohio here, it got even more detached. We kind of just forgot about it. And then I think at one point we might have even shut our Facebook page off, and then it got connected back on. And last night, over a source of different, I guess the word would be, instances with negative comments and negative people that it's just kind of been building, you know, and it just piles up. I mean, most of you guys are awesome, but then there are people that are just heck bent on trying to cause problems. But over the source of a lot of that, Krista and I were having a discussion last night on, should we do Facebook at all? Should we just ditch it? We're out. And then it got even to the question as to whether or not social media at all, and dare I even say YouTube, is something we want to have in our lives long term. And so we were having this discussion, and literally, for whatever reason, Krista was like, let's just look through these accounts. Let's look and see what has transpired. And we got a letter. We got a message. And I'm not going to read the whole message, but it came from a friend of the channel. It came way back in October of last year, actually, ironically, on Halloween. And this friend of our channel is one of the sweetest, most awesome people you'll ever meet. And her channel is called Bandana Grandma. And she left this comment that I'm not going to read, not because it's not awesome, but frankly, because I think I'll cry. And that's not a lie. She said some things in there that are just heart-touching, you know? Stuff that just gets you and goes, all right, calm down. You're doing the right thing. Just keep moving. And what we did was we printed this out, and I stuck it by my computer, and there's one down by Mama's computer. And when we get negative, nasty remarks, I look over and I read this now. And I go, you know what? That's just 1% or 0.5% of people who want to just destroy something that is good because either they're jealous or they don't like what we're doing, or for whatever myriad of reasons they don't like us. They want us to be gone. And I gotta keep myself in check. And so there are blessings all around you guys. Listen, I didn't even know this existed. It's been there since October, Halloween. How many times this could have come in handy? But no, it had to happen yesterday. And the reason why, I think, is because we were considering going, this ain't worth it. I can make more money, a lot of money, doing video production. I can do a lot of stuff that is technical, that people are willing to pay money for. Why am I messing around with all this nonsense, and it's just eating us alive? And then I got the reminder. There are blessings all around you. We just got to look for them, guys. Sometimes it's even in the pain. Oh, my gracious. The thing is this. We all go through garbage. There's no doubt. There's no doubt that a lot of you guys watching this are probably going through garbage. You might have horrible medical problems. But I'm here to tell you, it's not what defines you. There are blessings all around you. Look for those. Embrace the good that's still around. I'm not saying to pretend like there's magic fairy dust out there and you can just have a barn fairy with you and throw up hay and then all of a sudden everything's hunky-dory. I'm not saying that. What I'm saying is there's blessings around you. There are people that love you that you might not even be thinking of. My message is a message of encouragement for you today. Look for the good. There are blessings everywhere. Okay? Now, one quick thing before we end the video. I'm going to be putting more of our spiritual stuff up on Patreon. And this is not looking for money, so calm down. Matter of fact, a lot of the stuff, most of the stuff, in fact, that's there is free. You can go and look and see. But I'm going to put something up tomorrow that I think will be a blessing. And it's a story that happened to Krista and I when we were first married on basically trust. And it'll be up there tomorrow, if not the next day, but it'll be up there soon. And so I just wanted to encourage you, that's not going to be a charge. Just go and look and watch it. With that, there are blessings everywhere, guys. Embrace the good. You don't have to dwell on all the negative stuff. So with that, I'm Brad with the Big Family Homestead, and you guys have an amazing day.